स्पेशल मेंशन श्रीमती ककेसा परवीन,
विशेष उल्लेख के विषय को सदन के पटल पर रखती हूँ।
श्री प्रदीप टमटा, श्री प्रदीप टमटा, श्री बीके हरि प्रसाद नॉट प्रेजेंट, मोहम्मद नदीमूल हक।
सर कैन आई रीड इट प्लीज? सर देयर इज नीड टू रीअसेस इंडियाज ओडीएफ स्टेटस दैट इज ओपन डेफिकेशन फ्री। ऑन 2nd अक्टूबर Mahatma Gandhi's birthday, our country was declared to be open defecation free or ODF amid much fanfare this year. As per data recently released by the National Statistical Office, only 71% of rural households have access to toilets. The survey was carried out between July and October 2018. It found that states which had been declared 100% ODF before the survey began showed significant gaps in actual access to household toilets. Almost 42% of rural households in Jharkhand had no access to a toilet. In Tamil Nadu, the gap was 37%, while Rajasthan had a gap of 34%. In Gujarat, one of the earliest states to be declared ODF, nearly 25% of all rural households had no toilet access. The other major states listed also had significant gaps. Karnataka 30%, Madhya Pradesh 29%, Andhra Pradesh 22%, and Maharashtra 22%. Another cause for concern is that more than 50% of rural Indian households with toilets have septic tanks, while another 21% use single pit. In most cases, manual scavengers are employed to clean these tanks, which have resulted in their deaths. Only 10% of toilets were built with the twin leach pit system, which safely composts waste on its own without any need for cleaning or disposal. So I would urge the government to look into this and ensure that a country achieves 100% ODF status in reality.
Thank you, Nadimul ji. Sri Prashant Acharya.
Sir, the nation can achieve spectacular growth. No nation can achieve spectacular growth in economy without sound base in science and technology, which are directly linked to economic development. When our nation is poised for a revolution in manufacturing and infra, we need to move to create new research center on science and technology in firm IIEST, that is Indian Institute of Engineering, Science and Technology. There is plenty of opportunities in my state, Odisha, for industrial and technological growth. Hence, more number of IIESTs are required to be established in Odisha. The Veer Surendra Sai University of Technology, established in 1956 as an engineering college at Burla in Odisha, satisfies all conditions to be upgraded as an IIEST, for which the state government has already communicated its willingness since long. This engineering academy is surrounded by Mahanadi Coalfields Limited, NALCO, Vedant, and many other industries. It is also located very nearer to Sambalpur University, the Veer Surendra Sai Medical College, the Indian Institute of Management Sambalpur, the National Institute of Textiles, etc., which all will provide best training platform for the IIEST students. Its proximity to underdeveloped pockets like the KBK will be great help for development of the region. The recently opened Veer Surendra Sai Airport at Jharsuguda, which is nearer to the place, makes the proposal sounder. This institute has an impeccable record in academic performances and has zero student unrest. Thus, it meets all criteria enumerated in the Joshi Committee recommendation of 2004 for choosing IITs for upgradation to IIEST. Hence, I urge upon the government to upgrade VSSSUT as an IIEST at the earliest.
Thank you, sir.
Sri Ripun Bora.
Sir, my special mention to demand to expedite the pending cases of D. Bhutar of Assam in the Foreigners Tribunal. Large number of Indian citizens in Assam have been facing harassment and mental agony for years together because they were made doubtful voters and deprived from their voting rights. Now approximately 1.5 lakh voters of Assam are marked as doubtful voters. The process of identifying D-voters are initially started by border police, but in many cases, the border police, without conducting preliminary inquiry, refer them to foreigners' tribunal as D-voter.
Yes.
In foreigners' tribunal, some refer D-voters after completion of hearing process declared as Indian citizens. Out of 1.5 lakh D-voters, approximately 90,000 persons have been declared as foreigners, and now their cases are pending in Guwahati High Court. In foreigners' tribunal, D-voters have been moving from pillar to post for early disposal of their cases. But it has become a practice in the foreigners' tribunal to make inordinate delay in disposing of the cases. About 60% of the referred D-voters are declared as foreigners by foreigners' tribunal on ex parte decision, which is a gross violation of natural justice. In most of the cases, declared as foreigners are later on proved as Indian citizens in the appeal cases in Guwahati High Court. Sir, I call attention of the Home Minister through you to intervene in this matter and do the needful for early disposal thousands of pending cases in the Foreigners' Tribunal for maintaining justice by giving free and fair judgment without any bias. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Sri V. Vijay Sai Reddy.
Thank you, sir. With an objective to bring about an egalitarian society, the framers of the Constitution have inserted some articles providing opportunities to marginalized sections and protect the same sections from abuse. Taking a lead from this, SC-ST Prevention of Atrocities Act was enacted. The innate objective of the Act is to protect deprived, disadvantaged and oppressed sections of the society from any form of atrocity or abuse. The Act covers all listed SC and STs, but unfortunately, there are certain sections and Adivasi groups that are not covered under the Act. Sir, the nomadic tribes, denotified nomadic tribes, and semi-nomadic tribes form very deprived class in the society. We also call them as Sanchara Jatulu in Telugu. They are very vulnerable and subjected to lot of exploitation. The condition is worse than SC and STs, to which the Atrocities Act is extended to. An affirmative action right now to protect them from the abuse would enable them to live a respected life in the society. With this, I request the government to include the nomadic tribes, denotified nomadic tribes, and semi-nomadic tribes under the SC and ST Prevention of Atrocities Act. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Dr. T. Subbarami Reddy, to associate Dr. KBP Ramchandra.
Sir, I request the chairman
will you lay or eat?
To permit me to mention the following matter of urgent public importance in the House. Polavaram Irrigation Project is being executed as per the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act. Therefore, the central government should provide specific budgetary allocation for the project and pay the money directly executing the project. But most unfortunately, first time in the Indian history.
Please read. Please read it.
It's not
but as speak, today, but read text.
The finance ministry is asking NABARD to give the money. NABARD being a bank, it cannot give from its own funds. It has to borrow from the market. In 2018, 9,000 crores was allocated by the state government, and the central government approved only 1,400 crores, but not released, and asked NABARD to release the funds through extra budgetary resources. It is not fair and justified to give money outside the budgetary resources, which is taking abnormal delay, and the project is untimely delayed, leading the cost of escalation. The Polavaram project is completed would supply irrigation water for 7.2 lakhs acres and generate 960 megawatts hydropower and lift 8 TMC of water precaution barrage. It also aimed to supply 23 TMs of drinking water to Visakhapatnam. It will also solve the drinking water problem in 540 villages along with the Polavaram project. Now, the work at the site has been started and they hope to complete project in another 2-3 years. Therefore, I urge the Government of India, especially the Honorable Minister of Finance, to provide the budget sufficient funds to expedite completion of Polavaram and not to depend on the NABARD route system, which is unwarranted, unfortunate.
Thank you.
Bad.
Nothing is going on record except that approved text. Sir, have to associate. Sir, there is no text. No. It's only now I will call. Yes, K.V. Ramachandra, you have to associate only. Just you lay the subject, you lay your paper. You please lay. Dr. Santanu Sen, please lay.
Sir, my special mention is regarding not getting central government support for bulbul affected West Bengal. Sir, West Bengal has incurred a loss of 23,811 crore in the devastation caused by cyclone bulbul that has affected around 35 lakhs of people in three districts. Total number of 5,17,535 houses were damaged. Altogether, 14,98,924 hectares of agricultural land has been damaged. Power department has incurred a loss of nearly 597 crore. Team of central government visited the affected areas. Honorable Chief Minister Madam Mamata Banerjee requested central government for support to handle this disaster. Though the total damage might be to the tune of nearly 50,000 crore. And our Honorable Chief Minister, Madam Mamata Banerjee, has been extending all possible cooperations. But Government of India did not extend any support till date. So Government of India must take this very seriously to accelerate the helping process of the State Government of West Bengal, as our Honorable Prime Minister and Honorable Home Minister already tweeted before, assuring support. Thank you very much.
Thank you. To associate, Sri Manas Ranjan Bhuya.
Associate, I lay it.
Thank you. Sri Pratap Singh Bajwa, not present. Sri T.K. Rangarajan, will you lay or read? Will you please lay?
Special mention, it's a very important subject, mental health analysis. The World Happiness Report ranks India at 140 out of 156 countries. India is failing its citizen by not providing proper mental health facility. Bhutan, the first to release the Gross National Happiness Index, CNGH. UAE first create Ministry of Happiness. World Health Organization definition of good health includes physical, social and mental well-being. Mental well-being is an important as physical well-being. Socio-emotional development is more important than socio-economic development. Depression is persistent feeling of sadness and lack of interest, sadness akin to the sadness of losing your loved one and felt every single day. India is one of the most depressed country. Nearly 6 crores of people suffer and bound to grow. People below poverty line are affected more by stress, which leads to the depression, mostly manual labors, underskilled labors, working more than 14 hours a day, deprived of social contact, interaction, which increases stress factor, leading to depression, seeking alcohol or drugs with the cost of them, a fortune causing poverty. Stress among the youth is growing. Schools are a source of stress. Good marks leads to good college, which in turn leads to good jobs. Good jobs in India, not remunerative as a few other countries, leading to depression in some. Though India has started giving importance to mental health as early as 1982 by launching National Mental Health Program and various other acts, these concentrate primarily treatment than prevention. With the massive shortage of mental health professional in the country and rising mental health problem, prevention is best possible approach than treatment. Sir, I urge upon the government to take suitable steps in this regard and give importance to this matter. Thank you.
Srimati Vizla Satyanath.
Not present.
The House stands adjourned till 11 hours on Thursday, the 5th December 2019.